Hi guys, this is the Blue Shift One here. We're going to be using Worst Minecraft and building a chicken coop with no mods. So this is your basic Minecraft. You'll need a pretty decently sized area for this. This will do right here. I found this near my base. You won't need one quite this big, but you need a little bit of area to do this. Alright, so let's go ahead and take a look at what you're going to need. Of course, plenty of eggs, some arrows to put in the dispensers we're going to use. We're going to need about 9 signs, actually exactly 9 signs, some cobblestone and glass for structure, some empty buckets, a lava bucket, water, also need some redstone, 2 redstone torches, 2 levers, and 4 repeaters. Also, of course, you'll need your handy dandy shovel and axe to do all this. Let's go ahead and close that, and we'll go ahead and get started building. Alright, so getting started, we're going to make a big U. Basically, it's going to be 8 blocks by 9 blocks, so we'll start with the backside, which is 8. This is the width, basically, so make it 8 blocks. Then we'll make this 9 blocks, so we've already got 1 in the corner, so this is going to be already 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, make the other side the same length, so again, 9 long. Alright, so I guess now we're going to put up the dispensers, so drag those over, probably should have them there. One thing about dispensers, you need to be facing the way they're going to point, or in the opposite way they're going to point, so when you put them on the wall, you need to be looking at them so that they would be shooting you. And then we're going to build this up 5 blocks tall. I'm going to put my other dispenser right here. That'll be for the eggs. I'll explain more of that later on when we do redstone circuitry for this project. Now we just go into cobblestone. Like I said, 5 blocks high. One thing about, you can't put cobblestone, you can't attach it directly to a dispenser, because when you do that, it'll open up just like the little dispenser inventory. You have to actually go through and put it on an adjacent block like that. Click on the, so good. So yeah, we'll go ahead and finish going up this 5 blocks high. Making that wall. Let's see. It should be, 4 blocks. So we got one more to go. Alright. Yeah, one more. Continue building, of course. We're gonna make the roof out of glass. I like to see my animals that I started making or farming or housing or whatever. So of course, fill in the top with glass. Making that glass. It's always good to have a little bit of extra glass, because you tend to occasionally place them in the wrong spot and you get to break it. That's why I brought some extra glass with me. Oh, there we go, like that, because you do not get glass back in Minecraft. You lose it forever. The shards just disappear. Bring some extra glass when you're building with it. Nope, that's good. Just gotta remember to go fill in that little piece right there with some more cobblestone. I chose cobblestone for this project just because I had lots of it laying around. Sure, it's not the prettiest, but it does the job and is pretty strong. So this is kind of what you should have so far, just a nice big U. I'm going to put an access point, so some ladders to the top. I feel like it's more visual appeasing than putting some stairs. Also, I'll do them the other way, so we've got a piece of glass, and make a runway up there. Don't put one at the bottom, because that is where the water goes, and you do not disrupt the water flow. So yeah, there we go. Also, now we need to make a trench at the very end. It'll be two blocks deep. Hey, look at that. That's odd. Okay. So yeah, continue making your trench. I'm going to go through this wall right here. I'm not exactly sure how far. We'll work on that in a minute. That's a good question. All right, yeah, just keep on trucking through here. And eventually it needs to go three deep. Let's see, where am I? Wait, not this far. So yeah, need to go three deep. Staircase. Now we need to put up the signs. We'll need six signs for this right here. So drop them into your usable inventory. And we'll stick them right here. We're basically going to use them as a water blade system. It basically blocks the water from falling any further down or going under into this block. But smaller objects will, like eggs and chicken feathers, chicken meat, anything that's not a full block in size like water is, when it's falling at least. So yeah, we'll go across, and this will again block the water from going down into our little crevice. Right now I should make, this is a really useful technique, even though I have a water source here. This is how you make an infinite well of water. You make it 2x2 block, one deep in the ground, and two buckets of water, place them in opposing corners. This means now that when I grab some water, it actually doesn't deplete the water source, which is a nifty little glitch trick tool for having lots of water. This only takes a handful of buckets, but this is just a really, you really don't need anything more than two buckets of water to have infinite buckets of water. Now place this on this back wall. Probably want to like alternate blocks. It just keeps you from wasting water. Yeah, like I said, we have four blocks. Completely fills this. If you notice, if we go down now, we're dry. Oh my gosh. Such a cool little tool. This is pretty useful for any automatic harvesting. We'll place one down here, the conveyor belt system to us. And we will now... we need the other sign, or one of the other signs at least, and we'll do basically the same principle. I probably should have gone went one too far in, so I'll need one more block of dirt, and we will put the sign on that, and this should, yep, just like before, water bladed it out. Yep. Alright, so now we'll dig down a little bit. So I think I'm a little bit tight. Basically what we're going to do now is, this is why we brought the bucket of lava. Since we're not using any mods like the allocator mod, we're going to need to, basically, if we're not collecting eggs, it'll reduce our frames per second. So in that area, which is pretty bad, makes your gun look terrible. Give me my bucket. And so we want to, if we're not collecting, but still have all the chickens, we don't necessarily want to kill them. So we'll just send them to a fiery hell, or at least their eggs and their droppings. So now we're basically put a trap door over that, which is, oh no, I have this in my inventory. Put it basically as a trap door so that we can open and close it. Except for a trap door is only one block, so I'm going to need to only make this a one by one instead of a one by two. Maybe drop down. We'll just block it here. That'll be fine. Whatever. Let me get out of here. Alright, so I was saying, yeah, so we'll pour the lava down here. And we'll put a trapdoor now over top of it. Like that. Oh gosh, we're so good. Alright, so now we can pick up stuff or we can make it burn. We just need to get out now. So we need to get out. Yeah, there we go. Actually, we're gonna dig this out a little bit further and use some ladders since it has some extra pieces floating around. Yeah, we'll just stick it right here on the side so we can climb out. Oh, look at this. And then clean that up. We'll clean this up by doing this right here. So now we can go in, collect like bosses. We can also set it on fire if we need to. Oh, sun's going down. Last little bit we need to do is going to be to basically glass up the face of it so that it'll become a true containing box. Yep. Oh, no. See, that's why you don't want to click on it. There we go. Why you have extra glass? So yeah, glassing the face of it all the way. Sorry, my game's kind of getting a little bit my frames per second are lacking. I don't know. Sorry about that, but like I said, I'm just going to finish up glassing the face of this. It's pretty much the last step to making the basic structure of it. Last little thing. I guess I'll probably have to do this real quick. Ooh, it's getting dark quick. We're gonna go run over here and up the ladder to get that last little few pieces of glass, because while you don't need them, it looks nice. I like my things to kind of be somewhat aesthetically pleasing, but yet functional. So that's it. You just gotta hop off. And so there we go. That's what you should have so far. Now we'll do redstone circuits for the dispensers next. Alright, so we're working on the circuitry. First, let's check the inventory. I'll show you exactly what I have. I've already kind of modified my inventory for everything I need. Eggs, arrows, and all my redstone stuff. 6 cobblestone and 2 signs. So this should be everything that I'm going to need for this part. Alright, so first the cobblestones. We're going to make a 2-high pillar here and here. Just nice symmetrically oriented. Put the switches, the 2 levers at the bottom. Flip on and off the signs. This is where we're putting on the top half. These are going to put our arrows, and this is going to be a switch to launch our eggs of our 2 dispensers. So that's just for my reference. We need to put 1 cobblestone here and 1 here. And also on these need to go the redstone torches. Yep. So just stick those right there. Now for some redstone, we're gonna lay the switch. Just run it 2 here. Kind of follow as I do so. Actually, you know what? I'm gonna go and cut these on. Down is on in Minecraft for a lever. I'm gonna run out 1 and skip a block and run 1 here and then back. Oh yeah, I'm gonna just go in for the repeater here. Also bank it on the second setting on the repeater. That's just right by right clicking on top of the repeater, put in the second setting, run the rest of the block. But that repeater setting is for so it doesn't burn out, because this type of switch will burn out if it runs too quickly. You can put redstone a block below the dispenser like that, and it'll run just fine. Also, we're going to go and run this in parallel straight over to the other switch. This should be sufficient for making a flips, for making the repeater switch. So if I flip this, it blinks, yep, on and off, just like it should. If you notice, redstone only goes so far with the power. So what you can do is insert a repeater, it's like a diode, make sure it's pointing the right way, and it will basically power boost. So there you go, you've got a repeating circuit to the arrows, to both arrows. There's no arrows in there right now, that's why they're not shooting anything. So right here, we're basically going to mimic the exact same circuit. Bringing out 1, pretty sure I wrote it out 2 on the other one. For symmetry's sake, yes, I wrote it out 2. So same thing, run it from around the block. I'm supporting you run it just like this for if you'd like to get the exact same circuit. Second switches as before. We're not going to run them too close to each other, just because that means it will link them, and we do not want these linked. These need to be independent circuits. One of them are. I am a little bit, a whole lot of OCD, but I like it at least look straight. So this should do the same thing. If I flip it, it should blink. Same issue as before. I believe it's not quite making it. I'll run it back a little bit. Just for good measure, put a repeater here. So it's definitely bright enough. It's working just fine. So we'll turn it off so it's not blinking over and over again. Right click on here onto the dispensers to fill it. There's a probability based of which block is chosen from, but we're going to fill all of them so it won't matter. Now you could run these more than one egg dispenser and run in parallel like we did these arrow circuits. But for simplicity and time's sake, I did not do that. However, that would make egg dispensing a lot quicker. Just drop in the arrows just like you did the eggs. We'll flip the egg switch. You notice that we will shoot out and launch out, and you have a 1 in 8 chance of getting a baby chicken out of the out of each egg. And eventually the baby chicken will grow into a big chicken. Oh, there's one. And they will become, like I said, become big chicken and produce eggs. And you can kill it with the arrows and produce meat. That's about it. So I hope this was instructive. Thank you.